The global aviation sector has shown continuous growth before the pandemic. After a delayed recovery due to remaining travel restrictions, we have seen a strong rebound in growth last year, and this will continue this year.
So the aviation sector is clearly in need for a technology fix. And the beauty is that synthetic fuels can provide that technology fix. First, we looked at hydrogen, but the disadvantage of hydrogen is that it requires new airplanes to be built. The other option is synthetic kerosene, which can be used in existing airplanes. And there are basically two ways that synthetic fuels can be produced. One is the route of carbon and capture storage, and we label that as carbon neutral aviation. And there is an even more greener route, and that's called, we label that as net zero aviation. And in that way, the airplane still emits carbon, but since it is taken out of the air as well, the net level of CO2 does not increase. The main disadvantage is that at current price levels, synthetic kerosene is 7 to 10 times more expensive than jet fuel. We expect that these costs can come down by about 70% by 2050, but still it's our expectation that synthetic kerosene remains a relatively expensive way to power airplanes.
So what needs to be done? Well, in our view, there are three things. Awareness of the synthetic option needs to grow amongst corporates. Secondly, we'll have to make a start with investing in synthetic fuels. And lastly, governments could implement a sub-mandate for synthetic fuels in their targets for blending sustainable aviation fuels.
If you want to know more about it, read all about it in our article on our Think website.